Your name is Jesus. Your name is Lord. Your name is I am. Your name is Jesus. Your name is Lord. Your name is I am. Your name is Jesus. Your name is Lord. Your name is I am. Than any other name. Your name is Jesus. Your name is Lord. Your name is I am. Than any other name. Your name is Jesus. Your name is Lord. Oh yes, He's Lord. He's Lord. Amen. He's risen from the dead. He's Lord. Hallelujah. Every knee must bow. Every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is the Lord. He is Lord. He is Lord. He is Lord. Amen. He is risen from the dead. He is Lord. Hallelujah. Every knee must bow. Every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is the Lord. That wonderful name, Jesus. That wonderful name, Jesus. That wonderful name, Jesus. There is no other name I know. Oh yes, Lord. That wonderful name, Jesus. That wonderful name, Jesus. That wonderful name, Jesus. There is no other name I know. That wonderful name, Jesus. That wonderful name is the great physician. Jesus is a balm in Gilead. That wonderful name, Jesus. There is no other name I know. Oh, say glory, Father. Say glory, Son. Say glory, precious Holy Spirit. You deserve it all. Hallelujah. Say glory, Father. Say glory, Son. Say glory, Holy Spirit. You deserve the praise. Hallelujah. Say glory, Father. Say glory, Son. Say glory, Holy Spirit. You deserve the praise. Hallelujah. Say glory. Say glory, Father. Say glory, Son. Say glory, precious Holy Spirit. You deserve the praise. Worthy. You are worthy, King of kings, Lord of lords. You are worthy. Yes, you are worthy, worthy. Yes, you are worthy, my King, King of kings, Lord of lords. I honor you. You are faithful, faithful. You are faithful, you are faithful. King of kings, Lord of lords, you are faithful, faithful, faithful. You are faithful. King of kings, Lord of lords, I honor you. You are holy, holy. You are holy. King of kings, Lord of lords, you are holy. Emazebregedebe, holy. Yes, you are holy. King of kings, Lord of lords, I worship you. There is something that makes me run into your presence, my helper. There is something that makes me run into your presence, my helper. You are my helper, oh, my helper. You are my helper, oh, my helper. There is something that makes me run into your presence, my helper. It's your mercy that makes me run into your presence, my helper. It is your instructions that make me run into your presence, my helper. Your embrace that makes me run into your presence, my helper. It is your wisdom that makes me run into your presence, my helper. Your forgiveness that makes me run into your presence, my helper. It is your mercy that makes me run into your presence, my helper. Your power that makes me run into your presence, my helper. It is your glory that makes me run into your presence, my helper. You are my helper, oh, my helper. You are my helper, oh, my helper. There is something that makes me run into your presence, my helper. Yahweh, your name is Yahweh. Come on, praise Yahweh. There is none like him. Yahweh, your name is Yahweh. You are the covenant keeping God. Your name is Yahweh. He is Rapha, Rapha. Your name is Healer. He's Healer, Rapha. Your name is Healer. You are the covenant keeping God. Your name is Healer. You are the miracle working God. Your name is Healer. Oh, Nisi, your name is Nisi, your banner over us is love, Nisi, Jehovah Nisi, you are the protocol breaking God, your name is Nisi, you are the covenant keeping God, you are the miracle working God. You are the covenant keeping God. Come on, praise him now. He's Jehovah Nissi, El Shaddai, Adonai, Jehovah, El Gibor. We bless your name. Ayagadebra, Legadebra, Gada, Jehovah Mekadesh. We bless your name. Yeshua, Amashiach, hey, our Yeshua, our Messiah, Savior. Hey, Gadabarabayaba, glory and the lift up of our. Come on, begin to praise him, the Holy Spirit. Hey, Galebra, Gadebra, Gayaba. Oh, Rabagale Bregedebre Legesukotoniada. Eh, Baba 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 Legele Bragadaba. Oh, Paul said that we praise him in my understanding and that we praise him in the spirit. Come on, praise him in the spirit right now. Eh, Gale Bregada Bragado Bragayada. Oh, Rabagada Bragada. Hey, this is what I will do. I will pray in the spirit. I will pray with my understanding. I will engage my mind. I will sing rapturous praise to him. Come on, sing rapturous praise to him in the spirit. Hey, Gale Bragada Bragada Bragayada. Oh, come on, worship him. Hey, Zabragada Bragaya Baba. Inagala Bashinga de Bregesik Eselianda. Imbrambada Balaba. Imbrambada. Magusa Libra, praise in the spirit. My Libra Sagaya, my Libra Lavisa.
Yes, the Bible said in 1 Corinthians chapter 14, I read from the Passion Translation in verse 15. He said, oh, so here's what I've concluded. I will pray in the spirit and I will also pray with my understanding engaged, my mind engaged. You have to keep your mind engaged as you pray. I will sing rapturous praise in the spirit, but I will also sing with my mind engaged. You need to keep your mind engaged. Many of us, the reason why the prayers are not moving anything, the reason why it's not effective is because your mind is not engaged. You must not speak empty tongues. You must keep your mind engaged. You must pray in the spirit and pray in your understanding. And so today we are going to pray in the spirit and keep our mind engaged. Remember, focus is important. And we're going to use the scriptures to guide us. We're going to pray for 1 Corinthians chapter 2 from verse 4 to 10. You can engage that scripture anytime. But I want us to pray for building up ourselves in the most holy faith for the first few minutes, and then we'll be engaged in the spirit with that scripture. Father, we give you praise for the third day of this fast. Father, we give you praise because you said they go from strength to strength. Everyone in Zion appears before God. You said they looked unto him and they were lightened and their faces were not ashamed. Father, we give you praise for the privilege to mount up with wings as eagle, to come before your throne, to step on your holy hills. You said when we come to Mount Zion, we come to your city, oh, the supernatural Jerusalem. Oh, Father, you said we come to the innumerable company of angels, to the spirit of judgment made perfect, to God, the judge of all. You said we come, oh, Lord, Father, even to those whose name are written in heaven. Oh, Father, we give you praise for the register that here that bears our name. Oh, Father, we give you praise, oh, God, for the God who hears our prayer. Father, we give you praise for the angels ministering to us, even as we pray, as we fast, as we walk in your truth. Father, we give you praise because we are changed from one level of glory to another. Remember, the secret to answer prayer is to keep your mind engaged. Even when you are praying in tongues, I go so prakete. Zebra gese ketelianda. Zebra ba 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 ba. Hekala braga sukoto lianda. Shibraka sukoto. La bra ba 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 ba. Me braga telianda sepeke sukoto lianda. E braga dalianda sepeke sukoto. Father, as we come to you, how we focus on you. E griga soko sokoto. We cast our crown. Obeleda haladi. Lebrega lebrelede he. Lebrega sukoto. Ni braga sukoto lianda sapaka yagata. We call forth intercessors on this altar. How we call forth, O Lord Father, the truth. From the north, the south, the east, and the west, O God, from the four winds. In Nehemiah 2, we call forth, O Lord Father, the truth, O God, of intercessors, of apostolic watchmen, of prophetic intercessors. Father, we call forth, O Lord Father, and the warriors, O God, that we engage, O Lord Father, in battle at the gate. Men and women of understanding. Oh, Father, we call for to love for the Deborahs of our generation. We call for to love for that even the Baraks, oh God. Father, Lord, mega sopra sukoto. Zibranga sukoto, la branga sukoto lianda, isa branga sekata lianda. Father, we give you praise because it's a day of empowerment. Oh, Father, you said, oh Lord, Father, have you not known, have you not heard that power belongs to God? He gives power to the weak and to them that have no might to increase strength. Father, we give you praise because our strength is increased, oh God. As we exchange physical food for supernatural food. Father, we give you, oh Lord, Father, all the praise. We drink from your living stream. We drink from your living stream. We distract every distraction, we frustrate every frustration. Father, we make, O Lord Father, connection with your throne room. Exalt your name for the word in 1 Corinthians 2 from verse 4 to 10. The Bible said, my message. This is talking about Apostle Paul. He was addressing the Corinthian church. He said, my message and my preaching were not in persuasive words of men's wisdom. He said, he's not using clever rhetoric, but they were delivered in demonstration of the Spirit, the Holy Spirit operating through me and his power stirring the minds of the listener and persuading them, so that your faith will not rest on the wisdom and rhetorics of men, but on the power of God. Yet we do not speak wisdom among those spiritually mature believers who have teachable spirit, but we do speak wisdom among those spiritually mature believers who have teachable hearts and a greater understanding. But it's a higher wisdom, not the wisdom of this present age, nor of the rulers and leaders of this age who are passing away, but we speak God's wisdom in a mystery. The wisdom was hidden from man, but now revealed to us by God. That wisdom which God predestined before the ages to our glory, to lift up into the glory of his presence. None of the rulers of this age recognized and understood this wisdom. For if they had, they would not have crucified the Lord of glory. But just as is written in scripture, the things which the eyes have not seen. He said, just as is written in scripture, the things which the eyes have not seen. He said, the things which the eyes have not seen, nor the ears heard, which have not entered the heart of man, all that God has prepared for all those who love him, who hold him in affectionate reverence. Do you hold God in affectionate reverence? This secret is for you. He said, who obey him, who gratefully recognize the benefits that he has bestowed, for God has unveiled them. God has revealed them to us through the Holy Spirit, for the Spirit searches all things diligently, even sounding and measuring the profound depths of God, the Lord's divine counsel, and things far beyond human understanding. He gives them to us. He brings them to us. I want you to begin to pray. And if you look at that chapter in your own time, in 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 16, he said, who has known the mind of Christ that he may instruct him? But we have the mind of Christ. I want you to begin to activate that mind right now. I want you to look at this scripture and personalize it as much as possible. And we will close with the few prayer points that are listed in this instruction. As I'm a witness to you in this generation, come on, personalize the scripture and pray in the Holy Ghost. As I pray, as I preach, oh God, let my preaching, O Lord Father, not be according to the persuasive wisdom of men's wisdom. Let me not be, O Lord Father, let my word not be be according to the prayer, persuasive words of men's wisdom. Have not clever rhetoric, so God, let it be delivered, O Lord Father, in the demonstration of the spirit and power. Your power that is at work in me. Activate, O Lord Father, I stir up, O Lord Father, even your wisdom in my heart. Remember that the Bible says that the spirit of God dwells in you. He said, if you do not have the spirit of God, you are none of this. In Romans chapter 8, verse 9, he said in Romans 8:11, he said, the spirit that raised Christ from the dead dwells in you. Then the spirit that raised Christ from the dead, he said, it will quicken your mortal body. Oh, Father, Lord, I pray in the name of Jesus. Let your wisdom, O Lord, flow through me. The Bible said in Proverbs chapter 20, verse 5, he said, counsel in the heart of a man is like deep water. A man of understanding draws it out. Come on, begin to pray. Let your wisdom come out, O Lord, Father. Of my innermost being, of my inner man, oh yeah, of my mind, I stir it up. Paul told Timothy, his son, he says, stir up the spirit of God. He says, stir up the gift of God that has been given to you by the laying on of hands of the presbytery, by the words of prophecy. Come on, begin to stir it up. The Bible said, we do not speak the wisdom among those who are immature. He said, but among mature believers, with teachable hearts, with teachable spirit. Come on, pray for it right now. Oh, Father, Lord, help me to be teachable at all times. Help me to operate, oh, Lord, Father, in that humility that allows me to be teachable. In the name of Jesus, help me, oh, Lord, Father, to grow in spiritual maturity. Help me to operate the higher wisdom, not the wisdom of this present age, not the wisdom that will perish, not the wisdom that will pass away, not the wisdom of the rulers and the leaders of this age, not the wisdom of the principalities and power, but the wisdom of God. Oh, guys, he said the wisdom of God. He said we speak the wisdom of God in a mystery. Father, Lord, help me to tap into your mystery, the wisdom hidden from man, the one that is released to us by God, revealed to us by God, that wisdom which God predestined before the ages to our glory, to lift up into the, to lift us into the glory of his presence. This mystery is so special, it's so unique, it's so hidden, that the Bible said that if the Spirit, if the rulers of this age, if they understood this wisdom, they would not have crucified our Lord Jesus Christ. That is how God operates. He hides his mystery. He hides his mystery. I bet when Jesus Christ showed up in hell, the devil was stunned. When he took the keys of hell and death, the devil was stunned. He was shocked. That is the mystery we are talking about. The mystery that has the final joker. The wisdom that hung the earth upon nothing. The wisdom that put the seeds in their boundaries. The one that put the sun and his energy has never failed since the day he created the sun. The wisdom of God. The one that can be on earth and in hell at the same time. And the Bible says that the Bible makes us to understand that even in darkness, everything is light with him. The one that travels between heaven and earth, and we cannot see any physical highway. The wisdom, O Lord Father, the knowledge of creative invention. Oh, we tap into it today. Oh, the mysteries, O God. The prophetic mysteries, O God, we tap into it today. The Bible says, just as is written. Things that eyes have not seen, the ones that ears have not heard, which have not entered the heart of men, and the things that God has prepared for you who love him. Hey, everyone who affectionately reverence him. Father, we love you. We admire you. We adore you. We thank you because you first loved us. We love you too. And we receive, O Lord Father, this wisdom, this mystery, the secret bestowed upon us for our benefit. The Bible said God has revealed them. God has unveiled them by his Holy Spirit. For the Spirit searches all things. He searches all things, the deep things of God. The depths of God. Oh, the depths of God. The divine counsels of God. Things far beyond human understanding. Father, we press into this mystery. Oh, we press into this secret. Oh, we tap into this mystery. Oh, Father, we delve into them. Oh, by your spirit. Oh, Father, we pray in the name of Jesus. Let the words release from this altar, this prayer altar. Let it be delivered in the demonstration of your Holy Spirit and your power. During this fasting season, every single word, load it with your power. Let let it not be the persuasive words of human wisdom, not the clever rhetoric that becomes popular in this age. Oh, Father, we are praying in the name of Jesus. Deep mysteries, oh God, from the word as we study the book of Jeremiah. As we look at the book of Revelation, Father, we are asking, oh God, for deep mysteries, oh God, revelation, eye-popping encounters. Help us, oh God, help each one of us to grow in spiritual wisdom, spiritual understanding, help us to grow in maturity. How with the posture of a teachable heart, with a humble heart, help us, oh Lord, to grow in spiritual wisdom, spiritual understanding, with the posture of a teachable heart. Help us to be teachable. Grant us access to the mysteries hidden from the rulers of this age. Grant us access into the mysteries hidden, O Lord Father. Your hidden mysteries. You showed it, O Lord Father, to the patriarchs of old. You showed it to Abraham. You showed it to Moses. You showed it to Daniel. You showed it, O Lord Father, to Ezekiel. You showed it to Jeremiah. You showed it, O Lord Father, even to Paul. Yes, Lord, you showed him mysteries, O God. He went to the third heaven. He went to the second heaven. He saw mysteries, O God. You showed it to John, he saw the lake of fire, he saw hellfire, he saw heaven, he saw paradise, he saw your throne room. Father, Lord, grant us access, O God. Reveal the secret predestined for this season. Oh, yes, the secret, O God, your secret. You said the secret of the Lord is with them that fear him, and he will show them his salvation. Reveal to us the mysteries of the remaining days of this peculiar year. Show us the mysteries of 2020. Show us the secret that lies ahead in 2021 and beyond. Father, Lord, the secret that lies ahead. Father, Lord, give us the insight, oh God. Give us the secret. Oh, you said the secret things belong to God, but the things he revealed to us are for us and for our children's children. Father, show us secrets on this altar. I want you to pray and say, Lord, open our eyes. Open my eyes on all level of vision. Do you know that you are able to see with your spiritual eyes? You're able to see with the eyes of your mind, the eyes of your understanding. That's what the Bible calls it. And then you have the spirit, the eyes of your body. You can see with those three levels. At those three levels, you must be able to see. I want you to pray and say, Lord, open our eyes on this altar as we pray on all three levels. Let our understanding pop open, the eyes of our understanding. Oh, yes, Lord, I got the bread ghetto. The eyes of the spirit. Let us see visions of the day and visions of the night. Visions of the day and visions of the night. Let us see beyond the realm of the invisible. Let us see beyond the realm of the invisible. To the physical eyes is invisible, but to the spiritual eyes you can see it. To the mental eyes, to the eyes of the mind, you can imagine it. Let all barriers come off. Let the curtains fall off. Open our ears to hear. Oh Lord, on all levels, spirit, soul, and body. Let us hear beyond the realm of the inaudible. When God spoke at River Jordan, everyone heard thunder. But John the Baptist heard the voice of God. Jesus heard the voice of God. And those who had trained ears, they could hear the voice of the Spirit the same way. When Jesus Christ was on the mountain of transfiguration, the disciples and Jesus, they heard the voice of God. Other people heard claps of thunder. I want you to pray and say, Father, help me to hear beyond the realm of the inaudible. Help me to hear beyond the realm of the inaudible. Father, train my ears. Open my ears. Every plug that is clogging my ears, let them be unplugged. Let them be unclogged in the name of Jesus. Lord, instruct my heart. Instruct my heart. I submit my heart to you. I instruct my heart to perceive beyond the realm of the impalpable. Father, Lord, the things that cannot be felt or touched. Father, Lord, let me feel it. Let me sense it. Let me know it before they happen. The Bible said that the Holy Spirit will teach us all things. He will bring all things to our remembrance. He will show us things before they happen. The Bible said in Amos 3:7, the Lord does nothing without revealing to his servant, the prophet. Habakkuk chapter 2, verse 1 to 3 said, I will stand upon my water. I will wait upon the tower to see what he will say to me. He said, write the vision, make it plain. Father, show us vision. Father, let us hear your voice. The Bible said the Lord revealed himself to Samuel in Shiloh by the word of the Lord. Father, reveal yourself to us. Moses saw the burning bush, he heard your voice. Father, let us hear your voice in this prophetic company. Let us hear your voice on this mountain. Let us hear your voice down in this path. Let us see you. We give you praise and glory. There is none like you. There is none. Holy as the Lord, yes, Lord, there is none beside thee, neither is there any rock like our God. There is none holy as the Lord, Father, we exalt your name for this time of prayer, for this time of supernatural charging in the spirit. Thank you, Father, for the supernatural burst of energy. Thank you for renewal. Thank you for fire. Thank you for oil, fresh oil. Thank you, Daddy Lord, for a new intensity of prayer. Oh, Father, we give you praise, oh God, for consecration taking place, even as we spend time in your word, the washing of the water by the word. We give you praise for your hand that is resting upon us like Elijah. And we are outrunning all those who have gone ahead of us. Thank you, Eternal Rock of Ages, for the anointing of speed in this month of December, in every of our endeavor, as we wait on you, as we fast. Lord, we give you praise, oh God, because everyone who started this fast will complete it. And Father, we comfort all those who pertain to this company. We have not heard of this one. Let them hear. Let angels herald this program. Let angels promote, oh Lord, Father, this assignment. Father, we pray in the name of Jesus, all those who are hungry and thirsty for righteousness, let them come join us in the name of Jesus. Father, we exalt your name for answer prayer. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. Praise the Lord. Thank you so much for joining us. You could have been spending your Lord doing anything else. Thank you for joining us. All those who died in from the UK, all those who died in from Nigeria, all those who died in from Australia, all those who died in from Canada, all those who died in from all over the United States of America and other nations, God bless you. May your petitions be granted. I want to encourage you, observe the watches as you fast. That is what makes the difference between hunger strike and fasting. When you fast, when you observe the watches, when you pray scriptures, when you pray in the Holy Ghost, when you seek his face, when you praise him, then you will experience what is written in Isaiah chapter 40, verse 28 to 31. Please make sure you keep heaven engaged, even as you fast this season. Don't be distracted. Don't be distracted by the noise of the season. So remember to join us at 6 p.m. as we break bread together, communion and prayer. And then at midnight, as we delve into the word, God bless you. Let's share the Nehemiah benediction. I am blessed with the blessing of the Father God Almighty. I am blessed with the blessing of heaven above in Christ Jesus. I am blessed with the blessing of the field. I am blessed with the blessing of the deep within. I am blessed with the blessing of the breath. I am blessed with the blessing of the womb. I am blessed with all spiritual, material, and marital blessings this season. I am blessed when I go out and when I come in. My blessing exceeds that of my ancestors and all those who have gone ahead of me. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. God bless you. See you at 6 p.m. Bye for now.